Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in the previous session, we have already discussed about the encapsulation in Python. And in this session, we'll see, so what is meant by an abstract class and abstract methods. So abstract class and abstract methods. Right. So first we'll see what is meant by an abstract class. So coming to this abstract class, so class which contains only abstract methods. Which have abstract methods. So if any class is having these abstract methods, that class will automatically considered as an abstract class. Now the question is, what is an abstract method? What is an abstract method? So the method which is having only declaration but not the definition is called an abstract method. So method with declaration but not the definition. So that is abstraction. That means only having the essential part and hiding the implementation details, right? So we are in this, the abstract method is a method which is having only the declaration but hiding the implementation. That means it is not having any definition. So such type of methods we call it as an abstract methods. So if any class is having these abstract methods, that class will automatically considered as an abstract method. Sorry, abstract class. Now there is one more term called concrete class. See, concrete class. So what is meant by concrete class? So a class which doesn't have any abstract methods is called concrete class. The class without abstract methods. That means the class should not have any abstract methods. That is called the concrete class. Now, so here we are having one thing should be remembered, that object. So we are supposed to create an object to access the methods and variables of a class, right? So object can't be instantiated. Can't be instantiated or created for abstract classes. So if the class is an abstract class, we can't create an object for that class. So that means we can't access that particular abstract methods or the variables of that particular class. So in order to change that, so the object can only be instantiated for concrete classes. So the objects can only be created for the concrete classes. So how to change this abstract class to concrete class? So abstract class, concrete class. So how can we change? Means by using the inheritance. So whatever the class, so here this is the class which is inherited from abstract class. So we have to inherit the class from the abstract class, and here we have to implement or define all the abstract methods. Available in abstract class. So here, see, we said that abstract class is a class which is having abstract methods. For example, this abstract class is having some abstract methods A1 and A2. So two methods are there. There is no implementation, only the definition, declaration. So in order to make this abstract class as a concrete class, so we have to inherit the class from the abstract class, right? So we have to inherit the class from the abstract class, so that if you create the object for this one, this can be accessed to both the methods of concrete class and this abstract class. But here in the abstract class, we are not writing any definition. So we have to override these methods which are available in the abstract class in this inherited class. So hope you understood. So here we are having, for example, here we are having two abstract classes A1 and A2. So this is the class which is inherited from the abstract class. So in this class, we have to override these two methods. So that means we have to write the definition for all these methods. So if you fail to write the definition for all the methods, again this class will be an abstract class. So abstract class is a class which is having at least one abstract method. So if the class is having at least one abstract method, that class will be an abstract class. So all the implementation should be done, all the definitions of the classes should be overridden, right? So hope you understood this one. So we'll see the, if you are having any doubts, you can, your doubts will be clarified once I will execute the program, right? So here, two more things to be remembered. So for implementing these abstract classes, there is a module called ABC module. ABC stands for abstract base class. From this module we have to implement, so import, we have to import, so ABC class as well as abstract method. So these two classes should be imported from the module ABC. So this ABC is nothing but an abstract base class. So this is to maintain the class as an abstract. An abstract method, we will use it as a decorator. So whatever the method we are writing as an abstract method, we have to decorate that method with the help of this abstract method. So I will show you an example. So syntax I will show you, so that in the system, in the interpreter, we will execute a program. So if you want to make an abstract class, so abstract class, A class, right? So A class, and this should be inherited from the ABC. Then only this class should be an abstract class, right? So remember, so whatever the class we are considering as an abstract class, that should be inherited from the ABC class. ABC is nothing but abstract base class. ABC means abstract base class, right? So, and we are writing the method define some display. So we can use a keyword none. None means there is no information in that particular class. And this class is not, I mean this method is not an abstract method until you give the decorator. Okay, so this is, now if you implement this one, this will not be acting as an abstract method, because here we are not writing any decorator, right? So in order to make this class as an, I mean make this method as an abstract method, then use @ abstract method. So we have to use a decorator abstract method, so that this method will be acting as an abstract method. So once the method is an abstract method, automatically the class will become an abstract class. Right? So hope you understood. And if you want to convert this into the concrete class, so we have to implement one more class, some demo, which is inherited from this abstract class, right? And here we have to override all the methods of abstract class. So here having only one class, so here we can write diff display. Okay, here we have to write self. Okay, the first parameter is self. Self, and here we can simply write a print some abstract method. Right? So that implies this is a one more class which is inherited from the abstract class, so that this display method, whatever the abstract method available in this abstract class, has been overridden. So here we are writing the definition. We are writing the definition in the inherited class. So this class will be an abstract class and this class will be an concrete class. So one thing we have to remember, the concrete class means there must be not even a single abstract method. So whatever the class we are inheriting from the abstract class, all the methods should be inherited. That means, all the methods should be defined. So these are the things we have to remember while implementing this abstract class and abstract methods in Python. Okay. So this is very important. So first we have to import these two classes, ABC class and abstract method class, from the ABC module. And abstract method will be acting as a decorator for making the method as an abstract method. Right? So, hope you understood this session. So, we'll move on to the interpreter and I will show you by executing one simple program. Right? Let us move on to the system.
Hello friends. So, just now we have seen the theoretical part of this abstract class and abstract methods. So now we will see the implementation part. So with an example, so let us write the program. So first we have to import the abstract base class. So from the module ABC, import abstract base class as well as abstract method. So we have to use both abstract base class and abstract method to implement these abstract classes. Now let us create one class which is nothing but an abstract, right? So class some abstract demo, which is an abstract class. So here we have to pass ABC base class as a this one, because so this is nothing but the syntax of inheritance, right? So abstract demo is a subclass of abstract base class. So that means this will be also a abstract class. So here we can create one function. So I will write one function, just a simple function, some display, right? So here we can write a display function, and I am writing here none. So none means there is no code. So that implies this is only declaration but not a definition, right? So to make this as an abstract method, we have to use a decorator called abstract method. So the syntax is @ abstract method, right? So if you use this decorator, that means the method which we are writing, that is nothing but an abstract class. So in that there is only the declaration part, there is no definition part. So we can write a one more class which inherits the abstract demo, and such that we have to override the abstract methods which are available in this abstract class. Right now I will show you. So class demo. So in this class demo, sorry, it is an derived class from abstract class. Abstract demo, right. Now we have to write the definition for all the abstract methods in the from the abstract class. So in the inherited class, right? So because here the demo is the inherited class of abstract demo, so here we have to write the definition for all the methods, all the abstract methods that are available in this abstract class, right? So if you failed to write any one of the abstract method in this, so this class will also be acting as an abstract class. I will show you. So here I am writing, so display self. So I am just printing the name. Okay, so abstract method, right? So so if the class is an abstract class, we can't create an object for that abstract class. We can't instantiate the object for the abstract class. So the objects can only be instantiated for the concrete classes. So here the there is another term called a concrete class. Concrete class means in which there are no abstract methods is called a concrete class or a complete class, right? So here we cannot create an object. See, object is equal to abstract demo. So this is not possible because abstract demo is an abstract class, so we can't create an object for this abstract class. So I will show you the error. Okay, that's abstract demo. See, you can you can observe the error, type error. Can't instantiate abstract class, abstract demo with abstract methods display. So if you remove this one, so object can be instantiated for the concrete class. Here demo is the concrete class because demo doesn't have any abstract classes, right? So demo is an inherited class of abstract class, but here in this demo, whatever the abstract method we are writing in the abstract demo, that has been overridden with the definition, right? So see, so I will execute this one. See, there is no error. So just object has been instantiated, there is no error. So that means object can be created for only the concrete classes. So object dot demo. So this is the display. Okay, display is the method, right? So you can observe here abstract method. So let us take one more method that is an abstract method, right? So definition something show self none, right? So here this is also an abstract class. So if it is to make this abstract method, to make this method as an abstract, so we have to use the decorator. So at the rate abstract method. So with the help of this decorator, we can make the method as an abstract method. So now demo is an abstract, I mean inherited class, which have to implement all the abstract methods of this abstract class. But here I'm only writing the definition for only one abstract method. So I'm not writing the definition for show. Okay, then you can observe. See, again, can't instantiate the abstract class demo with abstract methods. So here demo class is not a concrete class. Demo class is also an abstract class because so demo failed to implement all the abstract methods of abstract class. So it is implementing only one method, but it is not implementing the show method. So if you write this one, see, if you implement this one, if you implement this one, then it will be worked. So you can observe. So that means this is an abstract class. So abstract class will be having only the abstract methods. The abstract method means only having the declaration but not the definition. And coming to the concrete class, the class which doesn't contain any abstract methods is called as concrete class. So whatever the class we are taking, that should be inherited from this abstract class, and that class should implement all the abstract methods of that abstract class. So here we are having a two abstract classes, display and show, and a demo is the inherited class of this abstract demo. So demo class should implement these two abstract methods in this class. So if it fails to define the any one of the abstract method, then that particular class will also be acting as an abstract class, right? So let us take one more example, I mean one more class. So demo one, see, and this is also the inherited class of abstract class. So here we are having two methods. One method has been implemented by one class and one method has been implemented by another class. Let us check the result. See, again can't instantiate, because so demo one is the inherited class of abstract demo. So demo one has to implement all the methods of abstract class. So if you write here, so I have written here, right? So I am taking demo 1 and object 1 dot display. So here you can observe the display method. Okay, similarly obj dot show, it will implement the show method. Right, so this class, so I am writing here in the comments, so this is a abstract class, and these are abstract methods, right? So this is also an abstract method because there is only declaration but not the definition. Right, and this is also an abstract class because only one method has been overridden. This is concrete class. This is a concrete class because all the methods of this abstract class has been implemented. So one thing you have to remember. So we, first of all, we have to import the ABC class from the ABC module, abstract base class. ABC stands for abstract base class, and also the abstract method for decorating this method as an abstract method. And this is also important. We have to use a decorator to make the method as an abstract method. Otherwise, it will be acting as a normal method, right? So these things have to be remembered while implementing this abstract class and abstract methods. So hope you understood this session. So if you are having any doubts regarding this any abstract class or abstract methods and how to implement these things, so you can feel free to post your doubts in the comment section. So that definitely I will try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my sessions, like my sessions, share my sessions with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So thanks for watching. Thank you.